Hello everyone, welcome back sa ating channel, and for today's video, we are going to discuss another concept about your community health nursing. At kung bago ka pa rin sa channel na ito, once again, my name is Joel Cruz Pascua, a lecturer. Pasensya na kayo sa aking boses. I've been doing some lecture series for the past few days, kaya medyo paos na po ako kasi 8 to 8 yon every day. Okay, 8 a.m. to 8, 5 p.m. and 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. sometimes. So, pasensya na kayo, and hope still able to understand my lecture for the day. And for please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit the like button po. And of course, comment na rin po for suggestions and comments po na gusto nyo paalam sa akin, and do not forget to share this video as well. So, the topic that we're going to discuss today is an important topic because this topic separates now the concept of community health nursing 1 and community health nursing 2 in the nursing school sa curriculum na meron tayo ngayon. Okay? So we're going to talk about the levels of clientele. Before we proceed to the levels of clientele, let me just give you a brief information about what a clientele is. When I talk about clientele po guys, from the word client po, client. So basically, these are the recipient of the services that we are giving, okay, as nurses in both hospital and in the community, okay. But let me just differentiate clientele to that of the patient. Pag sinabi po natin clientele, common po na ginagamit natin ang term na ito to describe the people who are receiving the services po sa community setting. And with regards to the clientele idea, ang clientele po is any person or any individual who is receiving yung ating services, okay, regardless of their health status. Kung may sakit man sila o wala, we will call them as clients or clientele. While in the other hand naman po, ang ating patient are commonly used term sa mga tao na nakaka-receive ng services that are confined in the hospital. Or in other words, ito yung mga client na mayroong sakit, specifically may sakit. Kaya yung mga pasyente doon sa hospital, ang tawag natin sa kanila is patient, while those who are in the community, whether they are well or sick, we term them as client po. Okay, in terms of the description or the difference between the client and a patient. Sana po maliwanag sa atin yung description na yon. Now, let's talk about this levels of clientele in the community. Let's talk about first the general concept about the clientele, okay, in the community. So, clientele in the community, we are referring to the general population. As we already know, the concept of community health nursing is more on prevention rather than the cure. Okay? Kasi ang gusto natin, we will try to improve the wellness or the health of the community people before they suffer from a certain illness or disease or disorder from the for that matter. So basically, gusto natin i-prevent na magkaroon sila ng sakit. Okay? So ang pasyente natin sa community would more focus on patient na well kasi ang gusto natin hindi na sila magkasakit. But of course, if they are already having disease but they are still in the community or confined in the community, or whether they are recuperating or recovering, still sakop pa rin sila ng services natin under the community health nursing practice. Specifically po sa public health nursing, if we are a public health nurse working in health center. Now, in terms of programs in the community, we follow the principle of greatest good for the greatest number. What does it mean? Okay, so in the community setting, okay, the data that we're collected from the community will be the basis in the creation of future programs. Now, these programs would eventually implemented in the community to address the needs or the community health needs or the family health needs identified during community health survey. Ngayon, okay, when we create the program, it is expected that there are some people in the community that would not agree. Okay, agreeing to this concept or to this program. And normal po yun, totoong nangyayari. But for as long as mas marami po ang makikinabang doon sa program na yun, okay, that we would still continue in the implementation of that program. Kasi nga, ang goal ng community health nursing practice is greatest good for the greatest number. For example, vaccination po. Vaccination, alam naman natin ang vaccination is very effective and it's already worldwide use. Okay, ginagamit yan ng lahat ng bansa. At nakikita naman natin yung difference ng mga vaccinated and unvaccinated countries. Okay, ngayon, kahit alam na natin epektibo ito, okay, or effective ito, there are still some groups in the entire population that still not agreeing to the practice of vaccination. And that is very much normal po. But for as long as majority of the population is getting the program or are accepting the program, then we are still on the good track because we're still following the greatest good for the greatest number principle under the community health nursing practice. Now, for the levels of clientele, we have four levels, guys. The first level is your individual, which is considered as the unit of entry. Before we go to a certain community or the community that we have chosen, okay, where we are going to conduct programs or community health surveys, we will not just automatically move into the community tas magbahay-bahay. Hindi po pwede yon. We have to ask permission. Ang tawag po natin doon, courtesy call. We have to inform the leaders of the community that us from the outside community will be immersing in their community and perform any activities na sasabihin natin sa kanila, and they have to be informed about it so that they will also inform their constituents na, hoy, meron pong mga pupunta na taga ganitong institutions na pupunta sa community, tanggapin po natin sila, nagpaalam po sila sa barangay. So basically, that is us establishing rapport within the community kasi kailangan nating inform sa kanila na may pupuntang grupo doon sa area nila. That is why talking to someone in the community, which commonly yung mga group leaders, like for example sa Pilipinas, mga barangay captain or parok leader, is an example of an individual and sila po yung magiging entry pass natin. Sila yung magdidikta kung papayag ba silang papasukin tayo sa community nila o hindi. That is why we term them as unit of entry. Now, the second level of your clientele is the family. As we already know, family is a group of individuals that live together with relationships, of course. Depende yan sa relationship na meron sila. Now, a family, okay, according to community health nursing practice, is the basic unit of service. Why is it the basic unit of service? Because when we go to the community, we will not try to solve the problems or concern or the needs of each individual community member. Okay, kasi mahihirapan tayo yan. For example, may 1,000 population sa isang area. And those 1,000 population has different problems and concerns on their own. Okay, at mahihirapan po tayo noon. And if we try to group that that 1,000 individuals into family, siguro meron tayong more or less mga sa 250 siguro kung there's an average of 4 members in each family. Okay? Now, in that way, mas ma-diffuse ng ating population na kailangan nating i-cover. And when we try to cover now the concerns of each family, we will try to cover kung ano yung common problem among all the members of a family. In that way, mas ma-reduce yung workload natin and of course, mas ma-target natin yung problema talaga na hinaharap ng isang pamilya. Okay? And that would also be the same dun sa the rest of the family of the entire population. That is why the basic unit of service is the family, because when you try to create a program, it has to target the concern of the family as a whole, not as individual. Okay, so that is the second level of family. Now, in some cases, we will try to describe what the family na in-interview natin, kung anong type of family meron sila. So what are the two types of family, guys? The two types of family, and by the way, before we proceed to that, let's go first to the major functions of a family, by the way. The major functions of the family is your socialization and reproduction. As we already know, kapag may kinakasal, sinasabi nung nagkasal, pagkatapos nilang may kasal, okay, humayo kayo at magpakarami. Kasi nga, one function of a family is actually to reproduce mga anak. Because this anak will become a member of the community later on and will continue to become a member of the community at sila po yung mag-nurture ng entire community. In terms of the socialization, responsibilidad po nating mga ng isang pamilya na makihalubilo sa mga tao sa community, na makihalubilo sa kanilang kapitbahay, at the same time to be active also and participate in joining activities spearheaded by the community leaders or the community officials. Okay? So dapat po nakikialam, nakikisali din tayo sa mga programa like cleaning activities, etc. and etc. and so on and so forth. Okay? Now, let me go back to the types of family, guys. There are two types of family, the traditional type and the non-traditional type. Madaling-madali lang po ito. Traditional type, may nanay, may tatay, may mga anak. Si tatay yung nagtatrabaho or the provider, si nanay naman po ang carer ng pamilya or stay at home. Inaalagahan niya ang pamilya. And that is a typical example of a traditional type of family. While non-traditional po, basta nagtrabaho na si nanay, kumikita na siya ng pera at nakadadagdag sa kita ng pamilya, that would become a non-traditional type of family. Now, in some books, may other types tayo meron or forms, which is based on composition, based on the locus of power, based on residence, and based on descent. So, based on composition, we will discuss that in a moment. Discuss muna natin ang locus of power. Pag locus of power, idugtong lang natin lagi yung mga suffix like pagmatri in sa part ng babae, patri naman sa part ng lalaki. Pag locus of power ang pinag-uusapan natin, who decides? Okay, who decides the most? Who has the more decisional power? Kung ang mas nagdi-decision is si nanay, matri, focal ang tawag doon. Pag ang nagdi-decision naman is si tatay, patrifocal naman po ang tawag doon. In terms of residence naman, locality naman po ito. Kung nakatira sila, kung taga saan yung nanay, ang tawag doon, matrilocal. Pag nakatira doon sila sa lugar ng tatay, patrilocal naman po ang tawag doon. At descent naman, kung nakatira sila together with the relatives of the family, matrilineal. At pag sa relatives naman ng lalaki, patrilineal. Again, sa babae, matri. Sa babae, sa lalaki, patri. Locus of power is focal. Residence naman po is local. And descent naman po is lineal. Okay? So, this is the base of composition naman. Meron tayong nuclear, extended, binpole, same-sex, cohabitating family, step-family, and single-parent family. So, very self-explanatory naman po yung iba niyan, like single-parent. Pag naghiwalay yung mga magulang, binubuhay na lang ang isang magulang. Okay? Step-family, pag may step-father, step-daughter within the family circle, step-family po yun. Cohabitating naman po, hindi sila magkano-ano by blood, pero nakatira sila sa isang bahay at kumakain at nagluluto sa isang kaldero, cohabitating family yan. For example, yung mga nagbo-boarding house together. Okay, na magkakaibigan. Same sex naman po, nandiyan example natin, gay couples, lesbian couples, binpole naman po up to third generation, extended naman po up to second generation nakatira sa isang bahay, at nuclear naman po, nanay, tatay, at mga anak. Sana maliwanag po tayo yan. If you do have any questions, just please kindly comment it down sa ating comment section. Okay, the third level of clientele is the group. So, group is basically the aggregate of vulnerable group. So, basically, i-divide lang natin yung entire population into subgroups na may commonalities in terms of their needs. Like, for example, group of pregnant women, group of children, group of LGBTQ, group of senior citizen, group of school-age children, group of teenagers. So, basically, this specific sectors of the society has different groups din po, or has different needs, or as commonalities in terms of their needs. Kaya po natin sila sineseparate or sinesektoral. Okay? Very important po ito, especially kapag magkocompute tayo ng health indicators and vital statistics, that would be our basis for the creation and implementation of programs in the community. And of course, the last one is your community. So the level 4 is your community, which is the entire client and the focus of community health nursing in terms of the clientele. So basically, si community po as a whole ang ating member, ang ating clientele, whether they are sick or not, rehabilitating or recuperating from a disease. Sila po ang focus. Again, let me go back to our basic principle. Greatest good for the greatest number. When we create a program, we have to focus kung ano ang mas makakabuti sa mas nakakarami. Okay, so that is your community of nursing. To sum it up, level 1 and level 2, yan po yung focus ng ating family nursing care plan. While level 3 and level 4 is ang focus naman po ng ating community health nursing process. So that ends our discussion for today's guys. Malakas ang ulan. I hope you are safe kung nasan ka ngayon. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Comment on this video guys. Click the share button and of course like din po. See you on my next video. Bye for now.